A little Nasty Gal haul for you guys. Very excited about it. Let me grab all the pieces. Ooh, that is cute. I'm so excited. Oh my god, I have a lot. All right, let me grab the pieces. I thought we'd go into my office. I'll try them on for you. And oh, this is so good. I'm so excited. And I'm partnering with them on this portion of today's video. And I feel like they definitely do affordable fashion the best. They really are a little bit more creative, I think, with shapes and their patterns. Like, everything is a little bit more well done. And you just know I love them. So let's go to a haul. Ow, this is so many clothes. I gotta put this down and we'll try on. Okay, so sorry, I've been working all day, so I'm just hanging out. So this is a very casual little haul, but I like casual, so I don't mind it. All right, I think I'm gonna start with this little satin top. It is so cute, so me. I have realized that I love satin. Like, I'm obsessed with satin. I will literally buy almost anything satin. It's just like a textile and material that I am always drawn to. Like, oh, anything satin, I'm like, I need it. It's just a big part of my style. So this is super cute. I would probably do, yeah, just like a little bralette underneath this just for safety. I kind of like how cropped it is though. You could maybe do something with beading at the bottom. It's really cute, or like a lace bra. And then I'm kind of feeling that it could be cute with these beige cords, which are amazing. Number one, these pants are amazing. They are like a 70s style, kind of flared bottom. I'd obviously need them hemmed because I'm only 5'2", but really gorgeous. And I really like it with the satin top. I think that's such a cute little combo. It's kind of giving me 70s vibes with the sleeves and everything. This is kind of rising up though, so definitely go up a size. This is a 4, I believe. US 4, I would have done, gosh, at least a 6 or an 8 in this, just because it's super, super cropped if you don't like crop tops. But really, really cute vibe. I love it together. And then I would do like a strappy heel or a boot, or I'd have to, it depends where I'd be going, but this dress is insane. I went for size 2 in this and it is super snug, but it's really tight around the legs. So I probably should have gone for a 4, which is my normal size. I don't know what I was thinking, but this is incredible. Look at the sleeves. I mean, this is insane. Now, I've also been on the hunt for a really nice oversized trench coat for the season. And this one is super oversized. This is literally a size 0, you guys, and it's massive. So, I kind of like that vibe though for certain instances. It has a hood on it. It is really nice, hardy quality. And just looks super like dramatic and amazing with the lapels and everything. I feel like for the price point, it's a pretty good jacket, and just really want to get into styling trench a little bit more this season. I love trenches. I think they're so versatile and cute. I am not a huge skinny jean fan. I don't think that they're out. If they fit your style, then definitely wear them. They don't, they're not super flattering on me, but I do love a black skinny jean. That's definitely a staple in my fall and winter wardrobe. So I wanted to test out some affordable pairs. These are pretty good. I think they run a little small. The denim's a little bit stiff, so I probably should have gone up one size, but they fit fine in the waist. It's like stretchy waist, but really like tight in the legs, which is, you know, really nice. So these are pretty cute. I also, this black trench, and I feel like this is kind of like a perfect outfit, let's say with like some boots, combat boots, maybe sneakers or something. Not sneakers with skinny jeans. I definitely do a boot. I feel like it needs to cover if you're doing skinny jeans. In my opinion, I like wearing them with boots or with like really flat sneakers, but This is really cute, which is like a little crop, and it kind of makes the coat make sense, but this is a really beautiful faux leather trench. Insane, so good for winter, and I just love it. Last piece is this beautiful, beautiful oversized blazer. I loved the colors of it. It's like cobalt blue and burgundy plaid. I don't know, I just, I'm really growing a respect for plaid again, kind of in like an old school Ralph Lauren way. I just feel like it's very classic, but if you mix it with modern shapes, I don't know, it can just be refreshed, I guess. So I really like this pattern. I think I would do this as like a blazer dress with a knee-high boot. I'm thinking something cool to, ooh, patent leather boots would be very like Clueless. That would be so cute. Or a knee-high boot of some sort, probably black. If I had blue boots, that would be amazing, but I don't have those. I don't know, maybe a hoodie layered underneath. I could see that. Really cute. So you can also wear this open for work. I feel like it's a fun play on pattern, but the pattern's not literally like obnoxious. I feel like it's still business appropriate. So really cute necklaces, even a heel, like strappy, colorful heel with this as just the dress is really cute. You can put biker shorts underneath just for safety or denim shorts, but so cute. Those are all the Nasty Gal pieces. Per usual, I'll have them down below in the description box. You guys know the drill with sizes and all of that. And we are about to get into the rest of the vlog, and I hope you enjoy. Hunter started power washing the porch, and we were so excited. This project we've been waiting to do. We need a leash for him. You take that. You tell them what happened.
All right, so we've been waiting to power wash the back porch. It's needed clean out for quite a while, and I started power washing it. It's a whole commitment because you know it's going to take like much longer than you expected it to. So finally pulled the trigger and decided to power wash it. Gave up going on a hike and stuff today to power wash this damn back porch. We moved all the furniture. We have a, like a cobweb pull that Savon recommended and Julie bought it. And we've been like cleaning up all the cobwebs and we're ready to power wash. Got it all set up, started power washing, and the hose.
Is it in there?
Oh yeah.
I've been looking for it.
Sorry.
Excuse me.
And started power washing and the hose was touching the motor. And so the motor like heated the hose up and it burnt a hole in it. And
are you sure? I think it got stuck under the corner.
No. It was burnt. It was burned.
Really?
Yeah.
God, I just got the sports bra in. Like, gotta get the padding out.
But, so the hose broke, it busted, can't work. I tried taping it with electrical tape because we didn't have duct tape. And I got it super tight. I worked on it for like 15 minutes and then restarted the power wash and the tape started like bubble up and then it blew.
Yeah, it's I guess it's like high pressure.
So we're on the way to Home Depot.
Oh my God.
I wanted Julie to come with me and she really didn't want to. And I was like, okay. I was even saying like, let's go look at home decor. Let's go look at like.
There's not a place that I like despise more than Home Depot unless I'm getting to pick out like tile or wood, which is probably like once every 5 years. So
I was even like, let's go look at like fall decor for the porch. Like, let's go look at just, I was trying to, I was trying to bribe her because I know that's what we're going to end up doing if she comes. So I'm like, let's go, let's do it. It's fun.
It's just so much work, Home Depot. I don't know what it is.
It's funny because when we go, I feel like we're having a great time, but it's because I'm having a great time.
No, I like hate it. I don't know what it is. Like, I want to like it because I like house stuff.
Yeah.
But there's something about it. It's just bad energy there.
Well, what's good about going, and I'm like, what I like when you come is we kind of can tackle everything we might need.
I know.
So it's not necessarily fun, but it's like, you know, I don't really complain about any errands that we run together.
I know. You're pretty good. I had to negotiate like a coffee stop.
Oh, it's always so sad when there's like an old person. They have the stretcher out.
That's so sad.
Anyways, I was trying to bribe her to go to Home Depot with me, and not even bribe her. I was just like, "Hey, would you want to go?" She was like, "No, I'm good. I'm gonna do some stuff around the house and whatever." And I was like, "Okay, cool." And then I started doing some more stuff. And I was like, "Hey, babe, I'm gonna go to Home Depot. You want to go?" "No, I think I'm good." And then I started bribing her, and nothing worked. And she goes, well, if you want me to go, I'll go. And I'm like, do you not see that I want you to go? Like, I'm saying, babe, you
want
to come
like,
with me?
Oh, you really want me there? I said, of course I do. Want me to go.
Of course I do.
I said, I'll come.
But I also want you to recognize that I want you to go without me having to say, hey, babe, I really want you to come with me.
Definitely. And I will admit that I probably need to work on that a little bit. And I will be better. You're really good at...
Well, it's also just an opportunity to get out of the house when you say, like, hey, I'm going to go.
I know. I just know we're getting out of the house later and we've got so much stuff to do, but I guess it's fine. I don't know.
And then we're like, let's bring Booker and get him, like, those are good, like, socializing things for him.
They are. Give a good adventure for Booker to get out of the house. Yeah, you want to go to Home Depot? Okay.
You know what's funny is when Noah was dying, like, when he was, like, kind of on his, like, last couple days.
Yeah.
My like final thing I did with him was I took him to a hardware store with me, and like he couldn't even walk. I carried him around the hardware store with me.
Yeah.
Just so he could have like, or maybe it was for me. It was like my final closure with him. It was the day before he passed, and I got in the Defender, put him in my passenger seat, and we drove to Ace Hardware, and I like carried him around the store, and like.
You carried him around the store.
Mm-hmm. It was like really sad, but it's almost like
significant.
Bringing those memories back because he's coming to the hardware store.
You're gonna come early. We're starting you so super early, okay? Maybe a vanilla bourbon coffee from Coffee Barista?
Sure. I'm not for that. It's kind of out of the way, but.
I know.
We could order for pickup and just hop by and grab them.
True. Okay, we'll call on the way out. That's kind of a yummy midday thing. We've been waiting 10 minutes for this kid to pee before we go in the store because we know he's going to pee right when we go in the store. Just
watch.
Well,
he's going to get excited.
He's going to get excited. And then he's going to pee. I just know it. You little shit. We're in Home Depot, Booker. Your first time. How do you feel? It's so super phones. Yay. Ooh, Halloween decorations. We're in the plant section. I said in case he pees, I'm going to go out here because... You never know. This seems like a better area to do it because it's at least outside. Those are pretty. Love those. Of course, there's the TT. Just a little bit. He got excited. Someone came up to him. These are lovely. Could we use these somewhere? I mean, how pretty. Look at like little peppers on them, and then they're really pretty. Where can we put them? Should we put some on the patio, the porch that we're power washing?
Sure.
That would look pretty, maybe. I really like them. You were successful. You did pretty good. Would you say so?
I don't care where we get coffees from, but just make a decision.
Okay.
Because.
Okay, I'll get them delivered.
I like having you come places like this with me, but.
Right.
You really delay things.
I know. Well, that's why I said, trust me, it's better if I don't go.
And you start a bunch of shit with me about grills and like.
Exactly. That's why I said it's better if I don't come.
You're such an impulse buyer, though.
I'm not an impulse buyer. I want.
You're like the girl. You're like the girl in Willy Wonka. It's like, I want it now.
No, I'm not.
You're like, I want a grill and I want it now.
I've wanted a grill. Literally, guys, you probably go back in our old vlogs and we've been arguing about a grill for literally, not like serious argument, just like going back and forth on a grill for years. Probably since our last house.
Listen, give the Traeger another chance.
Okay, fine. What I can't get over is that, like, you don't even use the Traeger, and you're, like, defending the Traeger and being like, let's give it another chance and let's use it, and it's like,
right.
but we don't even use it.
Right, that's why you give it another chance. You use it.
Okay, then I'm giving it literally, like, a month limit, and if not, like, we're selling that thing, or you can keep it if you want it to sit around and to collect dust, and then we're gonna get a different grill.
I'm only wanting, like, I don't need a month trial. I need, like, a week trial, but let's plan some meals on it.
Bro, I feel like I've been trying to plan meals forever on the grill.
Okay.
We talked about it 2 Sundays ago.
I know.
We didn't do it. You're not like helping that at all. Like, I feel like I
because
was like, let's make a grilled vegetable salad.
We were busy that day, and I was doing something, you were doing something, and then it, like 8 o'clock comes around, it's like, let's fire up the grill at 8:30.
Well, right. So what I'm saying is that I'd appreciate a little bit. Like, I feel like I've really been focused on. I try to plan the meals. Like, you, if I don't like bring up dinner, then you just like don't even think about it. And I'm just saying, like, maybe we can meet in the middle somewhere. Mm-hmm. Like,
Yeah.
Could you be like, hey, we said we were going to test out the grill, so let's do it. It's 6:30. Let's light up the grill. I'm going to go light it up, and then we'll throw some stuff on there because we said we were going
to
do
it. Yeah, I would offer to cook grill tonight, but I want sushi tonight. You can't make sushi on a grill.
I know, I'm not saying do it tonight. I'm just saying I need a little bit more participation in the grill debate from you.
And I need a little bit more of advance notice. We
literally grocery shopped for the grilled vegetable salad. Know,
and then we got busy doing house chores. Things that like won't get done unless I do them.
You know I'm a little bit right.
In terms of what?
Like, you haven't really like...
We're both right.
Yeah.
But yes, you're right. I
mean, I know you're doing other stuff. I'm not saying you're doing it on purpose.
No, I know.
Like,
I'm doing other things. Or it's like,
right, I know.
I'm working on a vlog and you're like, fire up the grill. And I'm like, we got to get this up in 10 minutes.
I know.
So.
But we can't let those things be excuses. Like, right. We just need to like do it.
Advance notice, like, hey, tomorrow we're going to grill. And all day we're
planning it
and prepping
for
it.
Tomorrow we are grilling.
Okay, let's do it.
Let's do it.
Great.
We're doing it.
And we can grill every Sunday night. Every Sunday.
We are grilling, and if you, like, this is my last chance or else, bitch, I'm ordering a grill. I'm not even telling you about it, and it's coming in the mail, and I'm going
to
set it up.
You don't have to not tell me about it. You can just order one, and we can order it together.
No, I'm not including you because you want to give the Traeger so many damn chances. Then we're going to do that. And if it doesn't happen, then, like, that's it. I'm not trying anymore.
Blamer.
Alright. Well, you know, we'll come to a conclusion. I agree. Maybe we need to understand the Traeger better to, like, use it to our advantage. But I feel like you know machines pretty well. And the fact that, like, we literally just haven't been motivated to use it at all, I think means that it might not be a good fit for us.
Yeah.
Don't you think? Have we even tried like grilling chicken breasts on there?
No. That's what I'm saying. I think we need to explore it and give it a true chance.
Okay.
We're writing it off just because like the two things we've cooked on it was a all day long smoked turkey for Thanksgiving and another all day long project that took 2 days because I did smoked trout.
How long does it take to warm up though?
No, it's not long at all.
Okay. Can you turn it on your phone?
Like right now?
Well, it's not plugged in.
Right.
But if you leave it plugged in, could you technically like be on the way home from the gym and be like, I'm heating up the Traeger? All right.
Maybe I just bought the Traeger sometime.
Oh my god. Oh my goodness. The irony is that like you researched it for so long and you really wanted it, and we've literally only used it one time in 2 years. Two times.
I don't think you care to grill. I think you want just this. You want this burnt, crusted flavor.
I know.
Which is fine.
Yes, which comes from a grill. And it's fun. It's like grilling, you know, the weather, and you like grill, and it's cute, and it's like fun. And you have people over and you do the thing.
No,
you know?
I love it.
And it's good times. But we're missing out on that because we're some dedication to this Traeger grill.
My biggest hesitation on buying a different grill is where we'll place it.
Yeah.
And what we're gonna be doing with our backyard.
I know.
I know where the gas connection is, but if we place it there, then it's gonna be at such a weird position. And literally that's the view you'll get from
the other side.
When we're in bed at night looking out our window, it's back of grill.
Yeah.
Like, can you just acknowledge that I'm trying to be responsible with like
the aesthetic of the
And it's not like we're like we're starving of hunger. We can make food other ways until we figure that out.
I know, and I do it. Yes, I agree with that.
Like,
I agree, and I acknowledge that.
Because I know the second we buy a grill, and it's gonna be a to move around, and you're gonna want to move it all around and hide it, and move it. You know, can you move it? I'm gonna sweep. Can you move? And I'm like, I don't want to with that. I'd rather like build one in. And come up with like a built-in kitchenette plan.
Okay, well, can we build one in like a month?
We can build one in whenever. I will brick it. I will do whatever it takes because we can't find a contractor to do for us.
No, we can't. It's such a problem.
That's like the one thing about Nashville, anyone trying to move here, is you can't get done here. No contractors follow through. And
I think that's anywhere with contractors.
We've never had as big of a problem. It wasn't like that in California. It wasn't like that in Texas. Like, people follow through with their jobs. So they at least follow through with a quote.
It's like pulling.
Or when they follow through with a quote and you're like, yes, I'll pay it. I'll pay double. Like, people are giving us quotes and we're like, I will pay. Let's go. Let's start tomorrow. And then they ghost you. Then they ghost you. They take the time to come out. They take the time to give you a quote. And then you say, yeah, it sounds good. I'll pay you that. Plus, I'll give you like 50% tip after you're done.
I might give you.
I'll give you BJ. I swear to God, I'll drop to my knees. Just do
give
it.
Me green grass.
God, it's so frustrating. And so with everything, painter, please just paint my house and don't paint it the wrong color.
Oh my God.
Don't freaking do the wrong way. Just do it right and do it now. I want it now.
Do it tomorrow.
It's so bizarre.
I'm desperate.
And I mean it. I'm not trying to hate on anyone that's from Nashville or living here now or maybe family, some kind of contractor. I don't mean to stereotype it. We just had the biggest issues finding anyone to get any kind of work done. I know people are having businesses are finding hard finding employees. I know a lot of everyone's busy right now.
Yeah, we're not
saying, get it.
Yeah.
We get it. It's just we're freaking hard to find it, and we've never had this.
And
before.
Don't even think about those of that. Just do it yourself.
Shut
yourself.
The f- up.
It's like you can't do everything. It's impossible. Or you literally won't have any time left. Like, you can't do that. You
can't do everything.
So don't say that. And you probably don't own a house. Yeah. You don't know. Okay. People are like, that's okay.
All right, we're gonna get a coffee. We'll see you when we get home. Good morning, everybody. It is bright and early. Still waking up. I'm on my way to the bank to get some cash because I gotta pay for a piece of wood that I purchased. It's a big slab piece of wood that is gonna be my desktop built into my shelving unit. So I think I showed before in a vlog that I'm having the bottom drawers of my desk pulled out. And then I'm gonna have a wood slab built in all the way across as like the countertop to that built-in area. And then it'll be like my desktop as well. But this slab is so big that I had to hire movers to go pick it up. The carpenter said he couldn't pick it up because the wood slab's too big. The lumber yard wood company that I'm getting the slab from, they said they don't deliver and that they've never not had someone come pick up their wood before. This piece I got, it's 4 feet wide by 16 feet long. So no one can fit it in their truck and their van. Really the only options were for me to rent a trailer and go pick it up. Then I started like calculating the cost in my head, like, all right, how much is it gonna cost to get a trailer? Plus all the time it's gonna take me to go over there, plus all of a friend's time. I'll probably have to have a friend come with me to help me load it up and into the truck, or into the trailer. All of that probably costs more than the $300 it would be to just pay a movers to go pick it up for me. So they go pick it up for you, they deliver it for you, they place it where you want it to be, and you get them for a total of 3 hours so you can have them do other stuff around your house if you have other furniture you need to move. So anyways, cash is king in negotiations. And so I'm paying cash for the lumber. Chase is not open yet. And so I wonder what my limit is on cash at the ATM. Let's see. I hit my withdrawal limit. I'm short by $200, but I have 100 in here. Shoot. I might have to go back home. I think I have a couple hundreds at home. What a hassle. I would have normally gone into the bank and just done the withdrawal at the window, but they're not open this early and I should have known that. Why aren't banks open early? Alright, well, so I not only grabbed a $100 bill, but I snatched Booker with me as well. Oh my gosh, good morning, you just woke up. I snuck out of the house this morning while he was still asleep. Mm-hmm. No, don't do that, I can't drive. Alright, we'll see you at the lumber yard.
It's like stuff like this. Like big slabs of wood. They have a whole warehouse full.
Alright, here she is. Is it weird that I listen to music like this? Like, we're like Friday Night Lights vibe. So now I got the woods loaded up in that moving truck. We're on our way home and I'm stopping to get Juju and I some Starbucks. So I had her order it to go and I'm coming to pick it up. What do you think?
Some walnut.
It's not walnut.
Oh wait, no, it's not walnut. It looks like walnut.
It's guanacaste. This is from Costa Rica. And I might stain it or do like an oil base on top of it to darken it.
Yeah, definitely.
Not stain it, but oil
like
it.
Like an oil. Yeah, but it's not as dark as I thought.
It's gonna be nice. I wonder if it's gonna look red with the oil.
Right.
I think here, let's do a test. This is what you do.
Okay.
There you are. Okay, just want to make sure I don't go too far, okay? That's good.
See the color? Get a little bit of water.
Oh. Oh, it'll be nice and dark, but it's definitely warm. It's that kind of warm color that you don't love. You know, I bet if you do, we should look up some like wood staining color theory. I bet if you do like a cool toned, maybe you can counteract the warmth with like an ashier stain to like, do you want to see like make it cooler?
Yeah.
But I'm sure. Oh,
what are you doing? What do you think of it? It's the same color as you. Look.
Pretty good. How's yours taste?
It's good.
It's kind of like old times.
Delicious.
Really?
Oh, by the way, we get a lot of questions. I don't know if we showed this before. We get a lot of questions about the piece from McKinsey. We love this piece that we got from
the art piece
done by her. But it started to separate.
Yes.
Not because of our movers, but because of the wood started to warp. This, not the art piece, but like the wood medium on the back. This piece, the wood, it started to warp and kind of like turn because it wasn't dried. Maybe it wasn't like dried out or aged.
We haven't gotten around to getting it fixed or fixing it. As you guys know, we're just like kind of going through like all the house stuff right now. So eventually we will do this. But yeah, it's just taking some
time. We're working with her to like come and schedule her to come out and like fix it at some point.
Yeah. Grass is going in tomorrow, y'all. Did we talk about the grass?
I don't think so on the vlog.
Yeah. I don't think we've talked about the grass on the on the vlog update on the grass, but we're getting new grass.
And we're using the same guy that messed it up. He is
He pulled through.
He pulled through and he's
we're working it out.
doing a do good.
Yeah.
And making it right.
Mm-hmm.
So he's replacing our grass.
You're not paying for it, right?
No. I have to pay for like some of the extra dirt he's bringing in, but okay. He's paying for the sod.
I mean, shockingly.
But here's the thing. We paid, like even when the grass was dying, we continued to pay for the maintenance. Like we were paying weekly for his maintenance, even though there was no maintenance.
Maintenance of dead grass.
They were
grass.
Coming and cutting the dead grass. And we're like, we don't need to cut, dude. We just want it fixed.
Oh, hello.
That's good.
And so we still, although we're not paying for the sod this go around, we paid for a lot of other things that
we probably shouldn't have.
Or that he shouldn't have made us pay for.
This is what we realized. We were like, all right, there's probably gonna be, in your whole lifespan of like house projects and things like that, you're gonna have hiccups like that where things just get messed up. You're not always gonna like get your full money's worth, your money back. You might get screwed a few times. And this is just, it's like, is it worth the stress of like all the back and forth and arguing and everything? And I think we decided at the end, like, we'll just take it, you know?
But anyways, it worked out. We got him to come in, and he's like, I think he's actually really trying now. Now that he kind of, I think he felt embarrassed because he's a pretty prideful guy. And I think he wants to make it right and do well, so.
Yeah.
They graded it yesterday. They raked out all the old grass and all the old netting.
We're like, damn, this looks better. We'll take this over.
So they brought in some dirt right here.
Yeah.
Some dirt right there, and then dirt down this side. You see the berms now?
Yeah, now I see them.
And so this will help with like the water flow and all kinds of stuff like that. And
we're stoked, you guys. I mean, look at that grass. Come on.
We're so excited just to get some good grass.
And you know what? We were laughing at our neighbors because they said they don't like their landscapers. And we were like, y'all, you have no idea. Yeah. Your landscape is fine.
Like, we'll take your
landscapers. We'll take it. We'll find new ones. Oh, you have the zoomies. Do you love the dirt? Wow. Good job. Good. Oh, yeah. We got some porch plants. I don't think we showed that.
No.
Okay, so, you know, in our efforts to distract from the nightmare that is behind us. Oh, I think I ordered some Instacart and it's here. we got some mums from the pumpkin patch and we love them. They're so pretty, we got a ton. And just from a local place, we got a couple of pumpkins. And we just thought it added a little zhuzh to the front porch. I think it's so cute. Until we get, we also need to get these flower beds put in. That's phase two of this whole landscape debacle, but we're just trying to nail the grass. But you guys, we're like, want to cry looking at this every day. Just, it's hard. We're about to just like maybe do it ourselves. Oh, thank you so much. You too. Booker. With the Instacart man. Oh, that's good. By the way, I was this girl that's really good at plants. I follow on Instagram and she was giving mum tips and she said, do not spray their leaves. They hate that. And Hunter was drenching them last night on the top. He goes, they like it. They don't like it.
I wasn't drenching them. I sprayed, I
you were sprinkling
their bowl up or their pot.
I know.
And then when the water was running out,
yeah.
I was then just kind of like letting it drizzle over to give them some life.
I know, but basically you're supposed to soak the dirt all the way through, but at the base of the dirt. Do not, she said they don't like to be wet on top, so.
Yeah.
Is that locked?
Time and Hunter's doing it, so.
Is that locked? Oh, shoot, okay. Okay, Book, let's go inside. Booker, Mr. Maraschino. What are you doing, little rascal? Come on. You menace. Get out of here. Let's go. Come on.
What are you doing in there? You're such a weirdo. Let's go. Come on.
Let's do it, baby. Come on. We're gonna start the day.
Hunter, did we want to give him those other pieces too?
Yeah. We can take a look at both of them.
Yeah. Here, I have scissors or box cutter.
That's cool too.
Yeah.
This is a menu we got at Bar Hemingway in Paris at the Ritz-Carlton.
So this is refreshing. You saw my post. I said, designed through millennials. So I like it. Everybody likes it.
Yeah.
Really pretty.
Warm and pretty.
Yes. Nice. Like that. And that's guest bedroom, I believe.
Yeah. So,
yes.
I wonder if what Chris thinks when he sees pieces framed in different.
Always, I'm always quick to do that. It's like, look, they work in different frames, right? I showed him a picture yesterday. He goes, it looks amazing.
Oh, good. Okay.
So I want to give a little more.
That looks amazing.
Yeah. Let's keep these corners on this
one. Okay.
Quick highlight of all the art pieces we got framed. One was this Chris Coleman piece. It's called The Alliance. But we did like a green frame with a black mat or like a gray mat. Got the Hemingway menu from Bar Hemingway. It's the Hemingway star. It's like a black frame with like a gold touch to it. And the mat is actually a suede, which is really cool. That is Hugh Glass, which is the character Leonardo DiCaprio plays in The Revenant. If any of y'all seen that, y'all know it's a true story. We got Julia's Chris Coleman piece. It's a heart. We got these in Nashville like 3 or 4 years ago. So it's kind of cool that we're now living in Nashville and getting them framed.
I know.
We got these three pieces that we picked up in Paris a few years back. We just got them framed.
Those are in the Paris vlog. If you watch us, you can see us picking those out on the street.
I know. I got this Norman Rockwell framed, more like an old-timey frame. And I actually bought this at an auction on a cruise ship years ago. These were, Julia made these at Fit'em, and she refused to have them framed. I told them out of the trash twice.
I'm so glad you did.
And then I forced her to get them framed. And they look fantastic. She did these over, you made these about 12 years ago.
This is when I was a freshman in college.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, you know, I'm nothing that good.
But they're really cool. It's like such memory.
I'm glad that you made me do that. But you know, it's your own thing. You're kind of like, oh, it's embarrassing. This is part of me.
Yeah.
You know?
It's super cool.
I like it.
But yeah, love all the pieces. It's so nice getting your art framed. We've had those art pieces for so long. I showed a lot of the art pieces in a vlog a long time ago, but we just now got them framed.
And finding a frame.
It's so important. Thing, you know? And now, once my office, bourbon room, library is painted, my little gallery wall can go up, so I'm so excited for that.
Did you know what's funny is that I still love boots. This is like, I don't have snakeskin boots. These are leopard, but you know. And then I'm actually like almost kind of recreating this outfit for my birthday look, I think, if it works out, which is funny. So these are still true to me to this day.
Yeah, you almost wore something like that last night.
I know,
boots exactly. Boots in the all black.
I know, literally.
Your mom's cool, Booker. All right, we'll see y'all later. I'm gonna go work out, and Joey's gonna go to the farmer's market to pick up a few things for dinner. Mm-hmm. So today's arm day. Julie doesn't really like to do arm days on Tuesdays, so.
I just have so much muscle, I don't really need any more. I'm just kidding. No, I don't wanna like, I don't need to like build my arms. I do plenty of push-ups and planks. No.
Okay.
I really want to the farmer's market because there's a hummus I can only get there.
I thought we could do the trigger tonight.
If we have time, yeah, we gotta take him to the park and we have a lot to do.
Okay. See, I'm the one trying to grill on
Jesus. Oh, whatever. You wouldn't even have a plan. You just say that. But you
no, I'm serious. I'm saying let's grill. You're going to the farmer's market, get some veggies, and we'll do like a veggie salad.
Well, I'll get some good stuff for sure. Okay, change this battery and we'll go to the farmer's. We're headed to the farmer's market. So we're going to the farmer's market in 12 South. I usually go to, well, when I have been, I've been to the Franklin one. With my friend Carly who lives in Franklin, and that one's really good. It's on Saturdays, but I think a lot of the same vendors are at the 12 South one on Tuesdays if you live in Nashville. And the reason that I've started to want to come to the farmer's market, which I've just never been a farmer's market person. Hold on, is this where the parking is? The reason I've been more motivated to go to the farmer's market, oh, there's a bunch of dogs here, I should have brought Booker, is because I'm finding it quite difficult to source really good ingredients like that are more like artisanal, I guess you could say. So based on like living in San Francisco, things like bread and things like bread or really really fresh produce, just like little things like that, I just feel like I can't really like nail down even at Whole Foods. So I'm gonna go check it out, see if I can get some local stuff. And there's also this amazing hummus that you can only get here, and I think it's a Jewish family that makes it, and it's literally the best hummus I've ever tasted in my life, and you can't get it at the store. So point in case, we're gonna go. I don't even know if I need my cardigan. It's kind of hot. Okay.
Oh, there's definitely a dog situation happening.
Oh, I totally missed it. Cute. Puppy pastries. Cute. All right, that was almost a complete fail. I did get a loaf of local bread, which is really exciting. So I think that's gonna be good, but the hummus guy was not there, so woof. That was literally the reason I wanted to go, was for the hummus. And then we totally missed out on the dog thing. It was like a dog day or event, but that's okay. I just have to get back anyways to bring Booker to the park. Because we go every night to meet the neighbors, and it's kind of like his time to play with the neighborhood dogs and stuff. And we go almost every night, we try to. And that's in like 30 minutes, so I'm glad I wasn't there for very long anyways. It's kind of like the farmer's market. It's more of, I feel like, a social thing. It's like vendors, and they actually had the farmer's dog food, which I've seen a lot of people on Instagram use. I would love to see if Booker would like that. I'm sorry. But yeah, so I only got one thing. Whoopsies. But I think maybe I'll do, I find that the
farmers markets in the South, like, since I've lived in Texas and Tennessee, like, they just don't really compare to California, and I guess I'm just jaded because I grew up there, and the food is so fresh. It's just, like, a weather thing, and, just different. So, this lady just totally ran over a cone. Okay. But there were so many cute dogs, and it would have been hectic if I brought Booker, though, and then it's like, okay, well, I only got one thing, so, oh, well. Sometimes, too, when I go to the farmer's market, like, you're like, do I need this? Because, you know, you see something, and it's like $12 for two lemons, and you're like, okay, do I really need these lemons? I think we could do without them, and then you've got to end up talking yourself out of everything that's there. Okay. This person is not going. So, that's all I got. But the bakery is in Santa Fe, Tennessee. I don't know where that's from, but it's multi-grain, and it's called Prevail Bakehouse, and it looks beautiful, so that was a win. But anyways, we're gonna go home. It's hot today. It's 83. I need to put on some shorts for the park, and then we'll go to bed.
Alright, y'all, it is late at night. Well, it's not too late. It's 11.
Pretty late.
Yeah, we usually get in bed by 10.
We have had quite the day.
We have. It's like one of those Murphy's Law days.
Everything that could have gone wrong went wrong.
Yeah.
And it was just one thing after the other.
We ordered skewers for dinner from this one place, and...
Wait, that sounds... You need the tea up.
Yeah, true.
So, you know, we've been dealing with the grass debacle while the grass... finally is getting replaced today, so that's the light.
That's the good news. We'll give that to you first, because that's about all the good news there was today.
Well, the bad news is that when they were replacing the grass, they cut our internet cord.
Yeah.
So our internet went out today.
Like 9 o'clock this morning.
Yes.
And we didn't know they cut it, though. They didn't tell us anything. They just put flags in the yard where they cut it, by the way. Did you know that?
Oh, just to like let you know?
To maybe let them know, reminder. I don't know. I thought maybe they would.
Well, just so happens their job is to upload videos onto the internet. So that's a problem.
Yeah, so we were like working. We're like, oh, maybe our internet will come back on later. Like, we just thought maybe there was like an outage in the neighborhood. And 3 or 4 hours went by, and I was trying to get the internet back on. Wouldn't come back on. So we're like, let's just go to a coffee shop. I texted the neighbors. Their internet was working. So I was like, shoot, something happened. And it's either the landscapers or they've been working on the internet in the neighborhood, but that was ruled out when the neighbors was working. Yeah. So I was like, shoot, the landscapers did something. So after all this landscape crap, after everything we've been going through with the landscapers and the grass and just the delays and the inconsistencies there, they finally here, and then they cut our internet.
Okay, so that happened.
So that happened.
So then, well, we were working on a work project, mm-hmm. and a bunch of stuff went wrong with the work project, and we have to basically like refilm a whole video.
And this morning, we were actually getting in the car to go to the gym, and the truck was behind us, and like they were nowhere to be found. So we couldn't get to the gym this morning, so we canceled our gym class. But we got our trash bins rolled up in time for the trash man to come.
Yeah.
Well, because the trucks were in front, they picked up every trash on the street except our trash.
So our trash is still full. And it's completely full, and we missed it. Yeah. Or they didn't pick it up. Okay, so then we're like, okay. Then we had some stuff going on with work, and we're like so stressed, and we're like, nothing's going our way. So then we're like, we haven't eaten all day because we were so stressed. We were like tired. So I'm like, cool, I'm gonna order from Zoe's Kitchen.
We're getting these, kebabs. Like,
kebabs. I've
done it before. It's usually pretty good. It's just some skewers. She gets salmon, I get chicken. We're like, let's just get something, fuel ourselves up. There comes with a side of veggies, all that good stuff.
We order the skewers, and the skewers get here. We're starving.
It usually comes with two or three. I think it comes with three. And I open mine up, and it has one little dinky skewer in there, and they forgot my other two.
We're like, we're starving, so I was like, please, great, no.
I'm just going to nibble on my fingernails. So I'm going to start my fingernail biting habit again.
Then we went to our friend's house to use the internet, and on the way there, we stopped to get a soda on the way. We wanted a sparkling water, and the place that we stopped at our soda fountain is down.
So it's now late. We had to go to a friend's house to upload the YouTube video, so we just got home at 11, and I got a text that our carpenter's coming in the morning for
my office, which is another great thing. We've been waiting for this to happen.
Yes, we've been waiting for the carpenter. With COVID, it's so hard to get materials, wood, everything. We've been waiting forever.
And I think I showed it in this vlog or a previous vlog that I went to go get this wood slab because we couldn't figure out anyone else to pick it up, or no one could figure out how to get this wood slab to our house. So we hired movers, we went and got it, all kinds of stuff. So it's just been, everything's one thing after the other. Everything's finally like lining up for us, but when it finally happens, like other things go wrong, which is part of life. We understand.
So now we have to unload the whole office tonight to make sure that there's space
for the He's starting at 8 a.m. in the morning.
I'm not even making sense. And it's 11 and we have to get all Hunter's book collection off of the shelves.
All the books, we gotta pull out.
There's my so couch, much crap in there.
Art, just, we've been, even you've been throwing a lot of stuff in there because it's been kind of like the catch-all room up front of the house because we haven't been using it because I've been working elsewhere. And now we got to clear out the whole office. So enough rambling. We're exhausted.
Bro.
But we're pulling out, like, we have all these boxes that were in there that's for our water filters that we're having done throughout the whole house. Which has also been an issue there. We got my couch here. So we're going to get started on that. We've already pulled out some of those things. And now it's time to empty the shelves. So let's do it.
Okay. Well, I can do, like, I just can't believe all the crap in here.
Shut up. This is, so, like, these are all childhood books.
Okay.
Like, ones that I plan on rereading at some point. That I said I read in school, but I never actually participated in the school readings. So I kind of feel like it's my humanly duty to go back and read.
Totally. Let me see if I read it in that book.
This is a boat I got. We haven't opened it yet, but it's a boat that I got. My hanging in my
Laura
office.
Has that. Okay, let's go up here. Alright.
Julie just doesn't respect other people's property. I'll tell you that.
Oh my right god. Now. Looking good, making progress. Okay. What is this tape measure? I mean, who does that? Can you leave this tape measure everywhere?
I do have some really cool trinkets and some cool stuff in here that I haven't shown before, and I'll show you next video.
It's so stressful to have things like out in your house everywhere, you know? Like, now we have all the crap that was in here. Like, and it's gonna have to stay for like probably 2 weeks just in the house. And I just hate that. Like, I want everything put away. Oh, it's nothing worse.
Nothing worse. Are these binoculars?
Night goggles.
Night goggles? Why do you have night goggles?
Here's Booker's birth certificate. Hungarian birth certificate. Kind of cool.
Really?
Yeah.
Let's see. Booker. Oh my god, you're a European man. That's so nice.
Your books. I think those are expired now. You want to live here. You would be wearing that hat while we had
what
we did. What? Just plastic. Okay, I'm gonna work on the books.
These are all, okay.
I'm gonna put all the books on this side and this one.
Yeah, all the important books go in there, okay?
Okay.
So.
All the important books.
Here's all my Hemingways.
Right here.
Ridiculous. Because you have much damn crap. You can't find anything.
Julia found my drill.
I mean, I cannot believe all this stuff. It's incredible. Oh, look at that. Sweet. Mr. Goozer. That was him. This is our old dog, you guys. who saves papers like this? It's like lists, like to-do lists. It's like, are you get the stress? Like, you're never gonna look at those again. Just throw them away.
Oh my God, there's more. Holy crap. I can't believe it.
I'm kind of worried about what you're doing over there with all that stuff.
I'm making a fun little station. It's a fun, cute area right now with all the best stuff on it. There's like, yeah, the drawers are a little bit of an issue because it's like a lot of paper.
I know.
Do you have any like stuff that you're throwing away? How do you feel like it's going?
Where do I put that?
Oh. Let's take a break.
No. Lou's probably so happy that this is falling apart. She's been wanting me to get rid of it for a long time. But, there's a hole in my bucket. There's a hole in my bucket, dear Liza. Dear Liza. She's gonna kill me because I put it in her office as her trash can. Right there.
We never learned we've been here before. Why are we always stuck and running from the bullets? The bullets. We never learned we've been here before. Why are we always stuck and running from the bullets? The bullets. Just stop your crying.
Box that I used to repose to Julia with. It's just like a random little wooden box with some ribbon around it. I don't know. Kind of cool. I hung on to that. I also found my vows that I hand wrote. It's like a few pages. I found like a letter that Julia wrote me in college. Kind of cool. Maybe I'll read it for you someday. Kind of cool stuff. Alright, I'm gonna finish up. I got all of these cleaned out, all the drawers. Now I just have to do one last section over there. What's taking place tomorrow is that slab I have in the garage, it's actually going all the way across right here. So they're removing that countertop and putting that slab in, and they're pulling those four drawers out. And that'll be like my desk right there. So I can have a chair sitting in there and my computer right there. So it'll be cabinet, cabinet with the slab all the way across. So it's pretty exciting. So they have to do that slab first. The carpenter's coming tomorrow. And then they're gonna paint the whole office black, like a blackish color. It's like a black, gray, charcoalish. The cabinets will be that color, and the walls and ceiling will be that color. So this whole room will be black, and it'll kind of match. Well, these drapes are actually a little bit lighter, so it'll be just darker than those drapes. And it'll look really nice once everything's dark in here. And then I'll have the leather couch, and it'll be like my bourbon library room, which will be great. I'm going to put a new light fixture in here and move that one up to a guest bedroom upstairs, which you'll see later on. Oh, that is it. Julia's been in bed for like 30 minutes, so I'm about to go join her. I might take a quick shower and then join her and maybe watch like an episode, if she's still awake, episode of something, and then yeah, we'll see y'all tomorrow. But good night, you guys. Just stop your crying. We gotta get away from
right, the wood slab is in place. And it looks really good. It was hard to get it in there. And we weren't afraid of like damaging anything like the walls because we're gonna sand it down and paint it all later. But one thing we do have to find, and we're working on it now, is wood to finish out this space here. Because when those drawers were removed, we figured there wasn't floor, but we figured we'd like check. But now we have to find probably like two planks to fill in that area. So that's next on the list. So painting will take place very soon, and the wood floor might take a while, but that's okay. But yeah, everything's looking really good. And I'm probably gonna stain the wood like a darker wood. I was wanting walnut, but I couldn't find walnut. And this was the next best thing. So trying to decide if I wanna leave it that color. I really do like it natural, but a darker stain would look really good too. To me right now, this looks really modern, and I'm wanting to go for more of like an old time feel. So we'll see. I'll probably make the decision after we paint it and see how that goes with the paint. How that goes with like all the paint on the cabinets as well as the walls, and then we'll decide. But I mean, right now it matches the vibes that are already in here. It's just like a little bit off color of the flooring, but it does match the columns. So we'll see. I don't want to make any like quick decisions on that. I'm gonna paint first and then staining. Coming back and staining this would be like super easy. So we shall see. And I like that that's more of like a bar stool height. And so I'll probably have like a bar stool workstation or a taller chair, so we'll see. Because that's not normal desk height. Normal desk height is about 3/4 of the way up, which is like right there. So we'll see what we need to do. But anyway.